In almost every episode on this channel where I have the Supra in the background, people blow up the comment section asking me to do a video where I show more of this car. I haven't had anything exciting enough to put this car in until now. This is my Toyota Supra in its entirety. This car has been in the garage for quite some time now. It's a long story. I had a triple disc carbon-carbon lightweight clutch assembly paired up with a huge turbo and 100mm throttle body. Giant. And to give you an example how big that is, I came up with the idea to mount the camera inside the intake manifold of the Supra a few months ago when I was switching over from the 100mm throttle body to this 75mm throttle body right here. I thought it would be really cool and interesting to see what's going on inside the intake manifold as I drive around the city the way I normally do, and that includes a lot of wide open throttle. Wow, it looks pretty cool in there. Oh man, check that out. You can see all those velocity stacks. I'm all done. I got the GoPro inside the intake manifold. It looks amazing. Check it out. It's a little glitchy, but that is our point of view. So now the next thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna get in the car, start it up, and go for a drive. This is gonna be super interesting to see how the throttle body is working, if you can hear the turbo through all of that intercooler piping, because that's directly connected to the throttle body. And I'm also really curious to see what the air is doing inside the intake. I'm only gonna run about 14 to 16 pounds of boost. I'm a little worried about those back two cylinders because the GoPro is like right in the way of the airflow coming into the intake. But I am curious to see what happens with that air inside the intake when it goes from about 15 pounds of boost right into a vacuum when I let off of the accelerator. And another cool thing is we can see right into that number four cylinder. We can see the two valves, the two ports, the injector right on top and the intake runner and the velocity stack came out way better than I thought. Let me get this thing started up, let it warm up, and then hit the road. I'm gonna just drive easy and then I'm gonna do a few full throttle runs and that's my plan. Let's get this GoPro out of the intake. I'm assuming maybe the camera overheated because yeah, it just won't connect. Here's the GoPro, and yeah, this sucker is hot. And I know I'm touching it with my hands. It's about, I don't know, maybe 200 degrees. It's not that hot because it's plastic and like, it's like rubberized plastic. But what I found really interesting is look at the back screen. Now the GoPro turned off. I got most of the footage. But if you look at the back screen, there's like a weird oil pattern where like there's only oil in the top and the bottom of the GoPro. And in the middle, I don't know, there's like no oil there. It's just, I found that weird that it has like that weird pattern on there. But if I touch the glass, it will burn me. It's very hot. Pretty impressive that these GoPros could take this much abuse. I mean, this thing, I don't know where all that oil is coming from, or if that smells like oil to me. All that oil wasn't in the intake when I started it up, but it is now. Interesting. I'm gonna look into that, that's for sure. I don't know what that oil is from, but that was really amazing footage. The smile on my face was from ear to ear when I pulled the GoPro out of the intake and I saw how cool that looked when I did that burnout. I've never seen anything like that before. But that being said, I didn't push it any further simply because I didn't want to damage the engine. I don't know what's going on in those back two cylinders having this GoPro in the way. And before anybody goes and tries to mount the GoPro inside the intake manifold of their car, I actually built some very specialized rigging to make this happen, which took me about 3 or 4 days that I didn't show on camera. Don't be mad about that. That's just how I get things done and how I get some of these really cool shots. But that being said, don't try to mount a GoPro in the intake of your car unless you call me first. So that was really amazing. Tell me what you think in the comments below. And that's all I got for you in this episode. This episode was all about the footage and just mounting a GoPro inside the intake manifold of the Supra. So thanks for watching. Check out all the other videos on this channel. See you soon. Everybody thinks having 1,000 horsepower car on the street is a blast to drive, and that's true sometimes, but I think the most pleasurable driving experience lies in between the drivability of the car and how much power it's making.